I think, like a lot of people, I heard about it from my kids because, you know, they were the first ones to discover the book. You know, a lot of adults know it now, but at first it was this huge YA novel. And they were raving about it when they read it. And then I didn't read it for a little while. I heard they were making a movie about it. I mentioned, you know, I remember that you were talking about this movie, The Hunger Games, and they just sort of purged and exploded about it. It went on, and I had to actually stop them from telling me the whole book. But their enthusiasm was infectious. So I went upstairs. I started reading about 10 o'clock at night. I finished about 1 or 1:30 in the morning. And literally put the book down and said, you know, I have to make this movie. I just have to. I was that taken with it, I guess the way many people are taken with the novel. And I literally got on a plane Monday morning and flew to England to see Nina Jacobson, who was the producer. I mean, it was that impulsive. I had to make the movie. It's really a story of Katniss finding her own humanity. You know, she begins this story as someone who only wants to fight for her own survival. She's somebody who is a survivor. She sneaks through the fence in District 12. She poaches food for her family. She's fiercely protective of her sister. And she has the mentality of a hunter and a survivor. But what she learns through the course of the games is really her own humanity. What she learns through the course of the games is to care about people other than herself. And she finds something that's even more important than surviving, which is kind of being human. And so I think that that's really beautiful. Susanna was really very special because we ended up actual collaborators. It wasn't just that she was involved, it's that we became a writing team. She came to, we were always talking, we had a good relationship, but then she came to LA. And I got her thoughts on the script, and her thoughts were so good, and it led to such an electric discussion between us. We began working together before we even realized it, and we were in this conference room, and I kind of looked at her and went, I mean, this feels so good. Why don't we just do this together? And she went, I'm in. And the next thing I knew, I had a writing partner again. The 12 various districts are being oppressed by the nation of Panem, by the capital, and understandably, they rebel. And it's the suppression of that rebellion that ultimately led to the Hunger Games, because this is a means of control. This is a way that they keep the districts in line. And if they can control the districts and if they can keep them sort of under their boot heel, then they'll be able to derive the resources. You know, from District 12, it's coal. From District 11, it's agriculture. All the various districts supply something to the capital that the capital needs to solidify their power base. So it really is the degradation of the culture and what they've been through that led to this oppressive system. And it was the need to constantly keep the districts under control that led to the Hunger Games. Katniss Everdeen is an incredible character. She's a fierce survivor. She's incredibly independent. She's a hunter. She has these amazing survival skills that she's developed over time to protect and fend for her family. And she lives in District 12, which is one of the poorer districts. It's a mining district. It's essentially in Appalachia. So they live with a tremendous amount of deprivation. And she's always been fiercely keyed into her own survival and has these amazing skills which ultimately allow her to cope and deal with the game. She's an incredible archer. She's phenomenally athletic. She's lived in the woods by her own wits. So she's remarkably suited to survive in the games as they're configured in this story. The Reaping is this large sort of public spectacle that the Capitol creates every year. It's a public lottery, almost like a draft lottery, in order to select the tributes. It's something that everyone in the districts feels with an approaching sense of dread every year. They know when the reaping is coming. They'll lose two of their own every year. Kids between the ages of 12 and 18 feel the specter of this thing approaching. And there's just sort of a looming sense of dread and fear that pervades the district leading up to the one moment when these names are chosen. It's their way of selecting the two tributes by lots. There's a mechanism within the game that allows someone to volunteer and to take the mantle of one of the people who's been selected, and so that they can assume that from them and volunteer to go in their stead. In the case of the careers, those are people who have been bred for this moment and are willing to volunteer because they want to go and fight. In the case of Katniss, it was a way of saving her little sister. And so she's placed in this terrible moment of having to actually volunteer to go in the games to save her little sister, and it's the first moment that you see kind of what Katniss is completely made of, that she would rather die than subject her little sister to this, which is really, really beautiful. It's also the seed, the first little shoot coming up of who she is. We see who she's going to become ultimately. When Katniss is first selected, she brings a lot with her, obviously. She's an amazing archer. She's incredibly athletic. She's lived in the woods. She's lived by her wits in the woods. She can climb a tree faster than anyone you know. She can hide in the woods. She has a highly developed acumen for being able to adapt to this environment and to hunt in this environment. So those are the raw skills that she brings in with her. She also brings, I think, a tremendous strength of character, which is that she has such an inner strength because it comes from a real place. At the end of the day, you know, Kato's strength or some of the career strength, it just comes from a kind of vainglorious place. It's almost like it comes from an attempt at achieving some kind of personal glory. Katniss is fighting for something larger. She's fighting for her little sister. It was definitely a different casting process than I'd ever been through before. You know, one of the great things about this is that it's a pretty big title in pop culture, and everybody has a very personal relationship to the book. All the fan base feels incredibly connected to it, and everybody has a very clear, very visceral idea of what Katniss Everdeen should be, or who PETA should be, or who Gale should be. So I'd never been through a process like this where so many people were invested with their own choices, but I thought that was wonderful because it just shows how connected to the material people are, how personal it is to them. They feel it's a book written for them, which is what, you know, Suzanne's monumental achievement is. And so, you know, both she and I embraced that. We thought that that was incredibly exciting.